Hey, good evening, friends. Welcome to another Wednesday night worship service. I'm so glad that you've tuned in tonight. Realizing today is June 1st. Can you imagine that? Where on earth has the first 5 months of this year gone? We're nearly halfway through the year already. Amazing. Anyway, we're going to have a time of worship. The worship team will come out and lead us, and I want to encourage us to sing along, to really worship along with them as they lead us. And then I'll be back in about 10 minutes or so, and we're going to look into a study tonight, looking at some ways we can use worship as a weapon against spiritual attacks. And we'll talk more about what is spiritual attacks. We'll get into that a little bit, and then these ways that we can use worship, different forms of worship, as a weapon against those spiritual attacks. But let's take a few minutes now and worship the Lord together.
Blessed assurance.
Well, thanks for joining in with that time of worship. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. Now, as I mentioned at the beginning, we're going to look at some ways tonight that we can use worship, its various forms of worship, as a weapon against spiritual attacks. Well, the truth is, friends, whether we realize it or not, or we want to admit it or not, we live in a spiritual realm. Now, we live in the physical piece of that spiritual realm, but we live in a spiritual realm. Many times, what we consider fleshly battles with other people or circumstances may well, in fact, be a full-on attack from the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places. Ephesians chapter 6, verses 11 and 12 instruct believers this way: "Put on the full armor of God, so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers and against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against spiritual forces in the heavenly realms." Amen. It's interesting to me that Ephesians 6 tells us to put on the full armor of God so that we can withstand the spiritual attacks. And then every piece of the armor that is listed in verses 14 to 17 refers to the person of Jesus Christ. That passage basically is telling us to clothe ourselves in Christ, to bear his truth and righteousness, to exercise faith in him, wield his word as our sword, and to trust in him as our salvation. In other words, abiding in Christ and worshiping him is our full defense against Satan's attacks. So let me give us several ways now to put on the full armor of God and worship him as our weapon against spiritual attacks. First one we're going to look at is this: say the name of Jesus. Friends, there is such power in the name of Jesus. Ephesians 6:17 tells us the armor of God includes the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. And then Acts chapter 4 and verse 12 tells us salvation is found in Jesus and no one else. For there is no other name under heaven given to mankind by which we must be saved. Furthermore, Scripture tells us that the word of God was made manifest in Jesus. We see that in John's Gospel, the first chapter. Simply put, friends, there is power. There is power and authority in the name of Jesus. So incorporate that power, that authority, not just by ending your prayers with the words "in Jesus' name," but start praising Jesus and who he is to remind yourself and the spiritual forces of darkness of the power and authority in that name. For example, you might pray, "Jesus, you are more powerful than my enemy." Or, "Jesus, when you are for me, who can be against me?" Or you may pray, "Jesus, your name is above every name in heaven and in earth." Or you may say, "Jesus, you have all authority." What powerful ways, using Scripture to begin our prayer times. Well, you see, when we say his name aloud through a praise or a call for help, you are enlisting all of heaven's armies, which respond to the beck and call of Jesus and his loved ones. Second way we can do this is to keep a heart of praise. 1 Thessalonians 5:18 commands us, directs us to give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. We talked about that just a couple of weeks ago. To give thanks in all circumstances, well, friends, it simply means to praise and thank him in the midst of disappointment, in the midst of heartaches, in the midst of pain. And those are often times when we are at our weakest and most prone to spiritual attack. You see, your praise in all things mentality, it may just ward off the enemy's attacks in the first place. Now, if you're like Job and you're being attacked in spite of your upright living, then I still say, obey 1 Thessalonians 5:18. And in that, thank God, thank Jesus, that he is stronger than any forces that will ever come against you. Thank him for how the trial or attack is developing you spiritually and perfecting and maturing your faith. As you keep a heart of praise, which is really the essence of worship, you are abiding in Christ. Psalm 22 and verse 3 says, God inhabits the praises of his people, or he is enthroned in our praises. When God is inhabiting the person of praise, Satan's attacks can irritate, but they cannot penetrate. Keep your heart and mind set on thanking God, and you will be wielding a spiritual attack with a weapon of praise. Number 3, sing the scriptures. One thing I love about the old hymns and even some of the newer contemporary worship music is that many of those songs contain direct quotations from Scripture, which makes them easier to memorize and then recite. All of Scripture's Psalms, which literally means songs, were all set to music and meant to be sung. So compose your own tune in your head as you sing the Bible Psalms aloud, or sing some Psalms or New Testament passages that have been set to music by 19th or 20th century composers, as contemporary music artists today will even do. As you sing the scriptures, you remind yourself who you are in God's eyes. For example, you are his beloved. You are his friend. You are his adopted child. You are God's masterpiece. When you quote scripture back to Satan, even as Jesus did when he was being tempted, Satan then knows that scripture and he trembles and backs off at the power of the written word of God. Next in line, number 4, would be this: pray scripture aloud. Just pray it out loud. We seem to tend to think that of worship as singing or some other form of praise. But the truth is, friends, worship also involves prayer. It involves reading the word. It involves quiet admiration and reflection on God and focusing on his worthiness. In fact, think of worship as a focus on God's worthship. I found that Psalm 145 in particular, it is effective for teaching young believers how to pray through the scriptures. Read each verse aloud and then paraphrase it, and then personalize it in a prayer back to God. For example, Psalm 145 in verse 8 says this: "The Lord is gracious and compassionate, slow to anger and great in mercy." What a beautiful verse. You could pray that back to God by personalizing it something like this: "Lord, you are gracious in compassion. Thank you for being slow to anger and great in mercy when it comes to your love toward me. I know I can bring anything and everything to you." You see, friends, by personalizing the word to your life and situations, keeping God's attributes and the truth of who he is intact within your prayer, you are then applying scriptures to your everyday life. And that is what it means to pray scripture over your situation and to use it as a weapon in a spiritual attack. Now, the last one we're going to look at tonight and think about is this: remember who has the power and authority. Perhaps you learned in Sunday school or believe today that God and Satan are equals. Let me assure you, friends, that is incorrect. And truthfully, it's a lie that the devil loves to propagate. You see, Satan is just another created being. He's a fallen angel, one who is still subject to God's authority and judgment. Satan's attacks are nothing compared to the almighty, omnipotent, everlasting God, who was not created, but created all things. The battle, and any battle of yours, truly belongs to the Lord. 1 John 4:4 tells us, greater is he who lives in you, speaking of Jesus, than he who lives in this world, speaking of Satan and his minions. Romans 8:31 asks a rhetorical question. If God is for us, who can be against us? You see, those verses, they build our faith in the one who has absolute power and authority. Truth is, spiritual attacks often come when we're already feeling defeated, or on the other end of that, when we believe we can never be defeated. Friends, we have to guard ourselves against pride and a belief that we are above attack by reminding ourselves that of God's authority and ability, not our own. Humble ourselves, humble yourself before the Lord, we're told in James, and depend on his power to get us through in every circumstance. According to Ephesians 1, verses 20 to 23, God raised Jesus from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion, above every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the age to come. God will put all things under Jesus' feet and he gave him as head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all. Jesus himself said this in Matthew 28:18. He said, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. So we begin to praise him for that authority. We call on him and his authority and realize the authority that you and I have in him as believers. When we worship and remember Christ's authority, we are also reminding ourselves and Satan of Satan's imminent defeat. So there we have it tonight, friends. Five ways that we can use worship, different forms of worship, as a tool, as a weapon against spiritual attacks. Because the truth is, spiritual attacks are always going to come. We seem to see them more prominently when we're feeling weak and discouraged, or we're dealing with anxiety, or after we've had a great victory. When we're feeling like we are on top of the world and nothing can defeat us, it seems in those two moments we're most often attacked. But the truth is, in our day-to-day lives, when we're simply striving to be more like Christ, when we're striving to learn the Word, when we're striving to share our faith, spiritual attacks are going to come. And sometimes they play out in the physical. And we've got to be aware of that as well. So we're going to close in a word of prayer. Use these, let me encourage you to use these five tools, five forms of worship as weapons against spiritual attack. Let's pray. Father, thank you for this night. Thank you for these tools, these weapons of worship that you've given to us to fight back against the spiritual attacks of the enemy as we trust in you, as we walk with you, that we can overcome and not be overcome. Thank you for your faithfulness in our lives, for the gift of your Holy Spirit, the gift of worship, the gift of prayer, the gift of your word, the presence of Christ Jesus in our hearts and lives. Thank you for your grace and mercy. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Bless the Lord. Well, friends, let me remind you, on Sunday morning at 9 o'clock, we have a Sunday school hour, classes for kids and adults alike. Then at 10 o'clock, we're here in the sanctuary for a time of worship and looking into the Word together. We'd love to have you join us. We also live stream our Sunday morning worship service on Facebook and on our YouTube channel. And then we're back here again next Wednesday night with another time of praise and worship, and then a Bible study, perhaps a testimony. I'm looking for some people that have testimonies, things that God has done or is doing in your life. And it's important for us to share those things to encourage others in your faith, in their faith. So if you've got a testimony to share, please give me a call, send me an email, send me a text. Let's get together and get that on recorded so that we can share it with those who tune in on Wednesday nights. Have a great night, friends. God bless you. May his favor and grace shine upon you. In Christ Jesus, we pray. Amen. Blessings. Have a great night.